Sorry, man. People are showing up.
That's good.
Yeah. People are showing up, Twit.
I know, I heard.
They hit me up, bro. I'm about to go out there. Yeah. Cool. All right. Thank you. I was born in New York. Lived in Boston for a little bit, but I was raised pretty much in New London, Connecticut. It's like Southeast Connecticut.
Mm-hmm. When did you move down?
There? Here.
Oh,
07. Into music. I just spent a lot of time with one cousin, a particular cousin, and he was into rapping. He had an older brother, so it was like his older brother was like, I want to say they're like 6 to 8 years apart, and you know, young, that's a big gap. So his influence on him became an influence on me because I spent a lot of time with Chris. And that's what they did, bro. They just, you know, they was rapping all the time and stuff. So I kind of started that way. And that was in 04. Yeah, and here we are. So. Yeah. Mad, this is quick. So we met last summer, or this summer, at a show in Austin. But it's been like 2 months. Like we met there. It was a different show, and that's why I tell people all the time, do your free shows, because that's what it was. I took the trip, had to, all the costs, I had to, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was no point in going if you do not purely do this out of passion. Like, why am I gonna go spend all this money for 20 minutes? But, you know, this came from that. And then immediately, basically when we started talking, it was about this right here. Like, this is what I got in mind. You know, we've been talking for a minute. Let me just kind of like clearly explain what it's gonna take for this to work for both of us. And they kind of heard me out, and like, you know, it was like a conversation. And I feel like that was the dopest part. You know what I mean? It's, the first thing that happened was like, oh, like
this was
like, yeah, like that's what I said. Like, thank you for, you know, because it's like, it's easy for somebody to say, but for someone to foot the bill for the show, it's not a cheap show. That's putting their money where their mouth is, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, him doing that is like me believing in myself that I can execute on it, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, it just all plays together, you know what I'm saying? I think you always tell yourself as an artist, if someone were to invest in me, that's all I need, is someone to invest in me, right? And that's what this is, you know? Oops. Like someone like kind of giving you everything you need, essentially, you know what I'm saying? So it's dope. I think you get little ideas of it coming together. And when you know you have the talent and the gift and all you need is time and you have the patience, right? You have everything you need. It's just like when you start to see it, it's almost like always in hindsight, you know what I mean? But like, it's like, all right, like you got to set goals, realistic goals, but if anything, set them ahead of the time you think it's actually going to be. Realistically, I mean, full-time artist, you know, I think that's realistic. It's easy to get caught up on like trying to make $1 million, but like really all you got to do is replace your job.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Whatever you're making at your job, that's goal number one. So yeah, I think it's possible. And I have a team now, like, because you need somebody to hold you accountable like that, you know what I mean? And that's why I tell them all the time, like, bro, I don't know how you can invest like that much time and effort into somebody else, because I, you know what I mean? Like, that's a special kind of person, man, for sure. There he is. What up, dog?
Good, my boy.
Chilling, man. Good to see you.
You too, man.
Welcome, Earn. Hey, Big Earn.
Did you find some kicks at the spot?
Nah. That's cool. I didn't have no business spending money unnecessarily, man.
Hey, man, you're a rapper. It's always necessary.
Yeah. See, that's what I was saying, man. Sa. We got wireless mics?
Don't stay the same, you can play inside. I don't expect to change unless somebody say one after one, same stuff, cover other aside. Go against Goliath that I'm stressed out. Big guy, 6'5", but acting like they just high us up.
Yep, mic check, mic, that sounds pretty. So close, we close. Mic check, 1, 2, yeah.
I don't want to hear that over a loud ass beat. And if you trying to speak super hard and fast, that's gonna sound bad. I promise you.
Yeah, right. How you feeling?
I don't like the sound check at all, man. I don't like the sound check. I don't like wired mics. I wasn't happy about that at all. So just glad I'm going fourth, you know? Figure it out. But yeah, it's not a, I don't know. That wire, you'll see, man. I'm gonna just be looking at the wire the whole time. I'm kind of upset about that, but I'll figure it out, I guess. Sound check's over? Yeah, we're good. Yeah.
Did it sound good over there? Besides the frequency, did it sound good over there? So what do you think, bro? How can we avoid that? Like, gotta stay away from the front?
No, make sure not to get too close to the head.
I just noticed that, like, it was like a ringing, and every time someone spoke, but it's because they're not using those, they're using these on the floor, and it's creating like a vibration.
Yeah, and it's like re-vibrating out of the hole.
Maybe
overall, it'll sound really good.
I mean, yeah, got everything I came in here thinking. Then the way sound check went. Then we got someone running late that's going on the first song of the night. That is real hard to stay in that mind space, man. But I don't go on for another 2+ hours, so that's why I'm not trying to, I don't know, I'm good. But yeah, that's where all the 20 things or whatever I was saying comes from. Man. Oh shit. Speaking of which, are you talking about Myron?
Yeah, Myron.
Yeah, I need to call his ass right now.
Oh, he's still here?
Yeah.
Oh, is he in your set?
He's in mine, but mine's is late. He's in the opener set too.
Yeah, he's late.
Hey, what's up, bro? the party room. Bro, what's so dope is that nobody's really stressing, but like, damn, there should have been at least 6 people here by now, you know what I'm saying? Like,
it's the same over there too.
For real? They're dead? Shit, I know they're coming, bro. Bro. He's gonna tell me that I cannot be your friend anymore, bro. Don't do it, bro. I was doing it, and then I moved to Texas. I met my wife now, my girlfriend at the time. She's from here, and we did the long distance thing for a while. We visited a while. We'd probably see each other. We met in like, so I was like 14. So up until I graduated high school, we would meet up like twice a year, 1 to 2 times a year. Then I graduated. She flew up there. We drove back to Texas. So like the first song I do tonight is about, like that was pivotal, right? It's nothing that I consciously gave up, but I started working and then trying to buy a house and trying to get education and had kids, right? So it was nothing I consciously gave up. Started doing it seriously 2021 after realizing that I was like, damn, like, there's just something I'm missing, you know what I mean? And that was actually at the same time I started walking, or started my journey with the Lord, you know what I'm saying? And it was just like, I felt like he spoke to me through a specific album, and then 2021, so about 3 years.
Let's go. Don't let the devil in. Stop.
Yeah, I think I'm already feeling like that's happened, like my dreams come true already, you know? Like, I genuinely, there's no doubt, right? There's no doubt, it's a matter of when. And that's clear. So it becomes it's just not real yet. You know what I mean? Like, I know it's gonna happen, but it doesn't mean it's gonna feel any less surreal. And I think that's gonna be the biggest, I'm working right now. Like, this is work, bro. You know what I mean? Like, the reality of that is gonna be dope. So, just kind of like, it's a lot of work, man. And you know what? It's a lot more work after things go well.
Just my nose zapping, my life, my peace.